I'm Dave Robertson. I'm a professor of applied logic and I'm the head of school elect for the School of Informatics at the University of Edinburgh. Probably I spend about a third of my time in administration, a bit more than a third of my time on research, and the remainder on teaching. One of the things that's kept my research quite fresh has been actually to do a lot of teaching. Every professor, every lecturer teaches, and the reason why is because students are actually very good at keeping you sharp. They're extraordinarily good bullshit detectors, and they force you to actually articulate your research quite well. My research is related to the internet and to building large-scale systems on the internet. The way that computers are starting to work now is in big collections on a large scale. At university, I did a degree in ecology. I was a biologist, not a computer scientist. So even in my undergraduate degree, I never thought of doing computing science. And I got involved in computing through biology because at that time, simulation work was starting to take off in biology. And then I was very lucky that I got onto another project right after my undergraduate degree that took me into what was and remains a world-leading research group in artificial intelligence. That was wonderful, and that really opened my eyes to what you could do with research, I think. So that was the big break for me, was at that point. And then my career just then continued, snowballed after that. When I moved into the artificial intelligence department, I had no idea what artificial intelligence was. None at all. I decided to do ecology because I was very interested in biology, and thought ecology would be the bit of biology that would give me the broadest background I could possibly have. After that, an accident happened. So there was a research project going on. It was a project on simulation for ecology. I was doing clever, smart stuff with simulation. And I was taken in as the ecologist. Possibly it was a bit risky, actually, for the people involved, because I was just an undergraduate, to hold up the ecology, make sure that was okay. Again, I was lucky, because at that time, the artificial intelligence had really taken off. This was the mid-80s. And there was really an awful lot of money being pushed into that from industry and from government. And I ended up doing reasonably well. The stuff that I was doing worked out. The department was growing, and I got a lectureship quite early. Even without a PhD, I got a lectureship, which is very unusual. So what I did actually was I did a PhD in Barcelona. The reason I could do that was because I was heavily involved with them in research. And it just seemed like a natural thing to do. I think with a lot of things in academia, what happens is that the subject actually carries you along if you're lucky. I've been quite lucky, or clever perhaps, in being able to be in an area where it is obvious that money has to be spent. One of the things that you learn in any decent place in academia is that everything is fiercely competitive. The fact that we get it is because we compete very, very fiercely against every other research institute to do the best research in that area. There are so many different ways of developing a career in research. And my personal history is unusual. So one piece of advice would be don't do the things that I have done, because a lot of them are not guaranteed to give you success.